In this video, we are going to show you how to install and commission the Fronius Backup Controller. With the new Fronius Backup Controller, you have now the possibility to have a very simple and compact full three-phase switchover possibility in your household. So the Backup Controller will now fully automatic switch over to backup power mode whenever the public grid fails. The controller itself includes already all the components that you need for a full backup power solution for an automatic switchover. So that means that even the FRT capability is included and you don't need any external switchover boxes and any components for the full automatic switchover. Due to the protection functions integrated in the Fronius inverter, you have now the possibility to have a very rapid switch off time in the inverter, and therefore an upstream RCD in the supply line to the inverter is no longer required. That means that your main RCD in the AC installation is sufficient to protect your household. However, please make sure to install this RCD after the backup controller so that it is operable during backup power times and that it secures your household even during backup power times. The backup controller is now capable of having a rated current of 35 amps and it is now available as a 3-pole version. However, in future we will also have a 4-pole version that includes the separation of the neutral conductor. So please make sure always to check back with your local grid supplier if you need a 3-pole or a 4-pole separation, and please note that especially when ordering the controller to order the right variant. If you require a higher current for a system, for a household system for example, please note that you can either use our Fronius backup power switch, so that means it is capable of doing up to 63 amps, or you can alternatively run other loads in parallel past the backup controller to make sure that these loads are being operated in grid parallel mode only, and when emergency power backup power is active, these loads are excluded from the backup power system. Please also note that you need to do a fusing of the controller with a max up to 35 amps to make sure that there is no damage and harm for the backup controller. So let's start with the cabling of the backup controller. Please note that we now have a demo installation, and of course in a real installation you need to watch all the national standards norms. So let's start on the top side of the Fronius smart meter. Here we go into the Fronius smart meter coming from the public grid directly three phase into the Fronius smart meter, and on the bottom we exit the Fronius smart meter and go directly into the backup controller. Please also note the installation requirements for the Fronius smart meter, and especially for example the protective cover that excludes the data communication line from the phases. Please also watch the quick installation guide of the Fronius smart meter. There you also find for example the neutral conductor that is needed for the measuring point, and therefore we have a very convenient function here. Since you can use the neutral conductor coming directly from the backup controller, it is noted here with a maximum of 1 amp, and you can directly install the neutral conductor clamp here coming to the Fronius smart meter to make sure that you don't need an extra clamp or extra cabling. Furthermore, we now go three phases directly on the controller. Please also watch here the grid symbol, so that means you have L1, 2 and 3 directly on the controller where you can now cable your phases to the smart meter and back to the controller. On the right hand side we have now our backup loads respective the household loads, and you see here you can now directly cable your household loads, your backup loads on the controller as well as the neutral conductor. Please also note there are two conductors for each phase, so L1, L2, L3, and please note you can use them to connect the Fronius inverter directly to the second connection of L1, L2 and L3 if you want to. Furthermore, we need of course a data communication for the backup controller. And this data communication, first up is our Modbus RTU communication between the Fronius smart meter and the Fronius inverter. To have a convenient way of installation, you can now use the Modbus RTU line coming from the Fronius smart meter directly on the backup controller. Please note, This line is only driven through the backup controller and you can exit it again to go to the Fronius inverter directly. So this is just for a convenient installation. If you don't want to do this, you can directly go from the smart meter to the inverter. Furthermore, we need to have, of course, our data communication to enable the backup mode and to stay in it. So therefore, we have the input, digital input 6 and input 7, as well as a plus 12 volt signal and our digital IO 0, as well as the ground contact to close the loop. So therefore, you need to cable these contacts to the backup controller so that it can enable the backup mode and stays in it. And therefore, you can directly go, for example, like we did it here, with one Cat 6 cable, you can directly go to the inverter, to the data communication of the inverter. And on the backup controller, you have written down on the data communication interface directly your contacts that you need to install. Furthermore, we have a little interface on the backup controller, and this will tell you from the front side in which mode the backup controller currently is. So we have one LED for the grid parallel mode and one LED for the backup power mode. So that means that even the end customer can directly see from the front side of the device in which mode the backup controller actually is. And depending on the current situation, the backup controller will now switch automatically between backup and grid parallel mode. The second side of installation is now the commissioning. And the commissioning of the backup power solutions I want to show you directly in our web interface of the Gen 24 Plus. You start the configuration process directly under the point device configuration and then under the topic function and IOs. Please note to always log in with your technician account since you need to be technician to alternate these settings. Down below here you find the point backup power and we need to activate backup power functionality on the inverter with this switch here. And after that in the drop down menu you can now start the configuration. First of all we are switching to, in our case, full backup functionality. And then we can set a backup power nominal voltage, in our case for example 230 volts. As well as the SOC warning level and the reserve capacity can be set in this mask. On the right hand side we have our digital IOs and please note we always recommend you to use the default settings, so pin 0, pin 7 and pin 6 for the activation of backup interlock, for the backup interlock feedback as well as for the open grid relay feedback. Since these are the numbers that are also written down on the backup controller, it's always the easiest choice to stay with the default values. So please make sure to configure all these three IOs. And when you are done, you can check back the configuration on the right-hand side of the page. And when you have that, hit the save button to conclude the commissioning. After this commissioning step, your solution is now ready to use and you can now use the backup power functionality with your new Fronius backup controller.